Welcome back to American Air Gunner, everybody. And I'm Chad Kettner, the Air Gun Advisor. And I'm going to be taking you through the HM1000x produced by RAW Airguns right here in the United States of America. Now, usually at this point, I'm going to go through a lot of the details of the rifle, but not this time. This time, I want to take you out and just give you a taste of what this rare rifle is capable of. And we're going to go straight to the range for those 50-yard groups. And as you watch this, that group right there is going to end up being 0.342 inches center to center at 50 yards. Now, it always seems that you pull one shot, but with an air rifle like this and a trigger like this one has, it wasn't the case. All right, let's go ahead and tear into this air gun just a little bit. You notice that it does come with a magazine, and it does, and I don't have it here in front of me, but it does come with extra O-rings in the unlikely event that you're going to need to repair one of those O-rings. And I say unlikely, but at some point in time in all air rifles, you will get a leak and you will need to repair your air gun. It doesn't matter if it's a $1,000 air rifle or $500 air rifle or even a $3,000 air gun, O-rings do have a tendency to go out. So nice of them to send us an extra set. What else you want to notice about this is this breech block right here is a solid aluminum breech block. Nice amount of room right here because I can put my finger in there and single load it. It does not come with a single loading tray, but that's all right. Plenty of room. You can get these in 22 caliber, 25 caliber, like the one you see in front of you, and also 30 caliber. Now, some other things. If you're looking at purchasing this air rifle, you're going to have choices. Now, the first choice is this beautiful laminated stock that you see in front of you. It has an M-lock rail at the bottom built in, adjustable comb here for your eyesight and your scope. It comes with a Minelli style butt pad, which is really nice if you already own some accessories like a Crawford and Lip or a PRS butt pad that fits Minelli stocks. It's also going to fit on this one. And then what I really, really like about it is that this air gun's set up for long distance shooting. If you notice the rail here, this rail, although you cannot see it here, matter of fact, you can't see it in front of me, it has a 20 MOA built in for those long distance shots. And you'll notice this scope right here does not have adjustable rings because I don't need them. It has that 20 MOA built in, and it really allows me to hit both at 50 yards and then all the way out to 100 yards as well. So nice features, great job RAW in coming up with this. Absolutely love it. One other thing you're going to notice, it does have a side lever here, and the side lever is very easy to maneuver. It clicks into place, so you're not going to have it flopping around. Very, very solid piece of equipment. The other option that you're going to have, if you don't want a laminate stock, is you're going to have this chassis system. The chassis system is also available, so you get the opportunity to choose from both. It's a solid, machined out of a solid piece of aluminum, super solid. There's no flex in it. To be noted, and again has the M-lock system built into the side rails as well as the bottom, and it comes with AR-15 style grip, so you can switch out the grips and then AR-15 style butt pad. And this butt pad, I'll tell you, is or I should say shoulder stock, is one of the best AR-15 shoulder stocks I have had that privilege of using. The adjustability of this, so you can adjust the comb again on it up and down. You can put the adjustment pieces left or right, so it's ambidextrous. As you know, I'm left-handed, so I have it already over here on the left-hand side. And then you can adjust the length of the pole, too. So you have this piece here that you can adjust specifically to kind of fine-tune it. And then at the bottom here, you have one screw that you can undo to kind of adjust it even further and get that longer range of pull right at the beginning as you start to adjust everything. So really, really high quality piece of equipment. Can't recommend this enough. Yeah, something that you should definitely consider if you're looking at this style of rifle. So what else is there to this rifle? Well, let me tell you, there's not a whole lot. And that's a good thing in my mind. As an air gunner, you know at some point in time you're going to have to tear into it and do some repairs, some cleaning and whatnot. And this is a really, really simple air gun to rebuild, to work on, to adjust. And those are the things that as air gunners, especially those of you who are looking at competing, like to have on an air rifle. And you're probably saying, well, how do you know? How much time have you actually had with this air gun? There's a channel on YouTube called the RAW Knowledge Center. Again, that's the RAW Knowledge Center. And I did all the videos tearing this gun apart, showing how to adjust it, adjust the regulator. And if you're at all interested in a HM1000x or even a TM1000, which is their target model, watch through some of those videos and you're going to see exactly how easy it is to work on this air gun. That means if I'm going someplace, going long distance, and something happens to go wrong, I have the ability to fix it on the road easily with the appropriate tools and not have to worry about a daggone thing. So you saw the 50-yard groups. You heard about the platform in general here. And again, everything is very, very promising. And you can probably tell that I'm pretty excited about this air gun. But again, you're probably wondering, well, what other kind of performance aspects can you share with us? And I'm going to do that right now. Of course, we have chronograph data. And the chronograph data is very, very important. So digging into that chronograph data, I was really pleasantly surprised with the results. The testing showed that on a 54-shot string, this HM1000X 25 caliber again was shooting with an average of 1,012 feet per second with a spread of around 35 feet per second and a standard deviation of 7.4. Now, I'm going to go ahead and pull up the graph here and just take a look at this because I'm going to tear into this just a little bit more. And what I noticed is if we limit our graph to just the first 31 shots on a fill, this thing with 31 shots was able to produce, again, a speed of now 1,017 feet per second on average, but a really lower spread of just 14 feet per second, and then an even smaller standard deviation, meaning how much difference between shots of only 3.8 feet per second. Are you kidding me? I mean, what else could you ask for in a rifle? You've got high shot count for plinking fun, and then if you're looking for that serious consistency for a competition, just limit your shot count a little bit, and it's right there. Let's go ahead and talk about the trigger system, which encompasses the easily accessible safety. You're going to see it down here. Just flick it forward. Probably the nicest safety or one of the nicest safeties I've seen as far as accessibility goes and how quick it is. But it comes with a two-stage trigger that is tunable for exactly what you want. And I did pull this one out of the box and just tune it just a little bit just to see what I could get. And holy cow, I was able to get a consistency after 8 consecutive trigger pulls of just 2.8 ounces. Now, that's not a typo. 2.8 ounces on a trigger pull means that you're not going to have a lot of jerk side to side. It again helps you get the best accuracy out of your air gun. And another nice thing about that 2.8 ounce trigger is that you could still feel the wall in there as you pull to get that shot off. So it's not something that you're likely to really mess up and accidentally fire the air gun and then mess up that whole group or even mess up your competition by accidentally firing the air gun too soon before you're on target. I do want to tell you one other thing though. This is the fill port right here. You hear me complain about this all the time, how you have to use fill adapters and so forth. Not this time. This comes with a quick disconnect. That is what I'm talking about. Come on, air gunners. Follow me up. Put that comment down below. Let the designers know that you like the quick disconnect on the fill system of your air rifles. Let's do that for everybody because the more they hear from us, the more likely they are to go ahead and incorporate it just like they have here with RAW. All right, air gunners, I'm out here at the range and I know you just saw 50-yard groups, but let's see what this thing can really do at 100. Let's go have some fun. Come on, hold it. A hole on hole, look at that. That's not bad. Let's do one more 5-shot group at 100 yards here. Let's see. Yeah, just came off the ringer at 150 bar. Let's go ahead and try this one more time. I can't end on that. What we're gonna do is go ahead and fill this up with a little air, get back on the regulator. If you're in competition, to really, really pay attention to what those gauges are saying on your gun, because you saw the first group, you saw I was on a second group that was gonna be just as good, if not better. And as I came off the reg, that changed the point of impact quite a bit. So let's go ahead and we're gonna get back to it. Oh man,
But that goes to show, if you're doing your part shooting this thing, you are going to end up with some amazing, amazing groups here.
All right, good day. Everything's set up. I was printing quarter size, nickel size groups at 100 yards.
Look at that. High five, dude. Was that fun? Hey, what did you think of that? Was that cool or what?
Cool.
What, do you want to do it again?
Yeah.
Tell them what you put out there this time.
250s.
250s. And what did you do with those 250s?
Stuck them on top of each other.
On top of each other. So we got a stack of 50s for the Firebird targets. All right. Oh! Tell them what you thought, man.
Sweet.
Obviously, this is my son here, and what did you think of that? I mean, if anyone's trying to get into, or their kiddos into shooting air guns, I mean, would you rather shoot paper, or would you rather shoot one of those?
Those.
What was fun about it?
I don't know, just a big explosion.
The big explosion? Could you feel the explosion?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's pretty cool, isn't it? I got one more shot for you down there. We got a Firebird 65 Bio. We're going to hit that and just have a little fun.
Bam! There is not much more that you can ask for an air gun that you can get out of the box. I just don't know what else to say about this thing, guys. This gun is really, really, really nice. So until next time, make sure that trigger pull stays smooth, pellets fly straight, and we're going to see you right here on American Airgunner.